Hello guys, this is my 60th video and it will be about interhalogen compound. I know you often ask to show chlorine trifluoride, but it's too exotic even for this channel, at least for now. Sorry, so today I will show you reactions with iodine trichloride. I'm holding an ampule with iodine trichloride, also called diiodine hexachloride sometimes, because in the solid state it is presented as a dimer. So let's open the ampule. This must be done very carefully. This substance is extremely volatile. You can see its dark orange fumes on a light gray background. We don't have much time because iodine trichloride is very sensitive to air humidity, so let's enjoy this beauty until these crystals didn't decay in the air. Wikipedia says that it's a bright yellow powder, but it's not yellow at all in the ampule next to its picture, yet it's of the same color as mine. The thing is that during prolonged storage or keeping in the light, iodine trichloride gets covered with elemental iodine, that adds such a burgundy color to it. So if we scrape off this thin layer, we will see the yellow color of iodine trichloride that we need. Temperature above 60 degrees Celsius, iodine trichloride decomposes into chlorine and iodine monochloride, that's a red-brown liquid. Now you can observe iodine monochloride flowing to the bottom of the tube. Iodine trichloride reacts with water in different ways, depending on the temperature of the latter. So at low temperature it is hydrolyzed by water slowly but completely, with the formation of iodine monochloride. In the reaction with hot water, you can observe gas evolution. Hydrogen chloride is actively released during the reaction. In the reaction with a concentrated alkali solution, we can detect chloride, iodide and iodate ions. If there are no other oxidizing agents in the solution besides iodate, the presence of iodate ion in the solution with iodide can be determined by the evolution of elemental iodine, that occurs due to acidifying the solution. Keep in mind that the acid must lack oxidizing properties in the solution. For this reaction, I use diluted sulfuric acid. Now I will show you a very interesting reaction with tin to chloride. Keep in mind that it must be anhydrous, this is very important. Tin to chloride is colorless crystals with strong reducing properties. Now I will add it to iodine trichloride. Have you noticed how quickly tin chloride crystals turned yellow? It's tin chloroiodide that gives this cream color. The main reaction leads to the formation of tetrachloride, iodine monochloride and elemental iodine. The smoking liquid formed during the reaction is tetrachloride, polluted with iodine-containing reaction products apparently. By the way, check this out, it is pure tetrachloride. See how nicely its heavy vapors spread around bottle walls. Well, now I will show you a couple of homogeneous reactions where self-ignition occurs. It is exceptionally cool to observe when both substances are solid. Red phosphorus instantly lights up on contact with iodine trichloride. Highly flammable lithium borohydride self-ignites too. Well, here is our favorite decaborane, that ignites on contact with almost any oxidizing agent. Oh guys, if you are still watching this video when you are totally hooked on chemical reactions and you really like my videos as much as I like making them for you, and if you'd like to see even more awesome videos with more exotic chemical reactions and more hard to get reagents and make sure they come out more often, you can now support me on Patreon. I can guarantee slightly more advanced videos with the reactions that were not included in the final cut to each and every membership level, because it wouldn't be fair if any of my patrons lacked access to exclusive videos. But no matter what your decision is, I'm not going to stop making new videos, because I still have many intriguing ideas and rare chemicals to share with you. Now let's take a look at the reaction of iodine trichloride with hydrolysis hydrate, that likes to reduce iodine in compounds with a positive oxidation number of iodine. Thank you. iodine reduction is completed. And this video is completed too.
I hope you really enjoyed the selection of reactions I have prepared for you. Thank you for viewing this channel. Many more exotic chemicals await your ahead. See you next video.